How's it going, everyone? This is Trainer Connor. You're watching my Eevee training tutorial for Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire. All right, let's begin. For those who are not aware, Eevees are known as effort values, and they raise a Pokemon's stats immensely. You can get Eevees by defeating any wild Pokemon or trainer. So, in the end, you are Eevee training, but you don't know it. But this tutorial is going to show you how to Eevee train correctly for those who are getting into the competitive battling surface here in Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire. Now, there are two very important things that you have to know when you're Eevee training correctly. First off, a Pokemon can have up to 508 Eevees maximum. The total number is 510, as a lot of people say, but it's actually 508. Why? Well, there are two stat points that don't matter in the end. So you can scratch those off and you get 508 maximum. That's the total number, guys. That's very important. Keep that in mind. 508 Eevees maximum. The maximum number in one stat. So you can maximize two stats. One stat will give you 252 EVs, and if you maximize another stat, you get 252 more. And that's going to equal 504. Now that means you have to get four more. You can put those four extra points in a different stat. This is the most common EV spread by many players that they use. But you can Eevee train however you want, as long as it equals 508 Eevees. Alrighty then, now, how you get those Eevees? Well, you know that you get Eevees by battling wild Pokemon. There is a way to speed that process up, though. Here's what I'm talking about. The easiest methods to Eevee train your Pokemon are going to be using vitamins, power items, Pokerus, those are going to be your best friend when it comes to Eevee training correctly. If you apply that to horde encounters in the game, you're going to get a ton of Eevee points. To get horde encounters, you have to get a Pokemon with Sweet Scent. For example, I have a Venusaur knowing Sweet Scent, and if you use that on the battlefield, then you'll encounter a horde every single time. Just FYI. And in the description of this video, I'm going to have the horde encounters list and what Pokemon that they appear in and the EVs that they give. So go down in the description, take a look at that, and I'll give you guys the number of times you have to fight that horde. Alright, and last but not least, we have Super Training to wrap up the process of the EV training tutorial, I guess. And that's pretty much it. So if you are still confused, feel free to put a question down in the comments. I'm not perfect, you guys. I did the best I can on that. It's pretty much very simple of a set, you know? But if you're still confused, leave a question down there and I'll answer the best I can. Just give you guys a little bit of more clarification. If this video was useful, be sure to like, spread the word around on this video, and I'll see you guys all next time. And be sure to subscribe to see some Eevee training Pokemon in action in my Wi-Fi battle videos. Have a good day!